So in our last lecture, we have seen the example of frame analysis by Bowman distribution method. But in those frames were like symmetric frame, loading was symmetric, and also geometry was symmetric. That means in those frames, sway was not there. Okay. So if in a frame sway is not there, we can analyze that frame by conventional method like we did in the continuous beam, okay, straight continuous beam, okay. So that is similar process. But in case of in case the geometry is not symmetric, like it is mentioned here, you can see geometry is not symmetric, no symmetry in the geometry, and in the loading is also not symmetric. So in that case, it is likely, it is most likely that the frame will sway. Okay, it is most likely that the frame will tilt, okay, by a small amount, maybe in the left side or the right side. Okay, so in that case, if there is some deflection, okay, or displacement of the joints, that means you see, in our previous lecture, we have seen that if the any load by some small amount, some moment is developed. Okay, some passive moments is moment will be developing, okay, due to that deflection. Similarly here also, if any joint is displacing towards left right, so some moment will be developed in this frame, okay, and that moment will be shared, will be carried forwarded by and distributed to the other member also. That's why we have to do the moment distribution method, okay, to find the final moment. Okay, so what I said initially, we will try to understand the method, and then some confusion may be there in the method, but it should be very clear. It should be crystal clear to you after solving one or two numerical. So you have to be patient. The patience should be there. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so the method we will understand. So here, so first thing is that you will look at the frame, and you will see that this is unsymmetric beam, maybe from geometry and maybe from the loading. Okay, you have to identify that. After identifying, you should know that if there is no symmetry, so there will be some sway. Okay, so see, this is one of the generalized example. Here we have a frame, and you see that the length of the height of the column is not same. This is L2, and this is, there is some mistake. So you can see this height is not same. Note this, what is written here. Okay, so you see the height is not same. Okay, so that means this frame is not symmetric from geometry, and you see there is a load from the left which is acting on the right side. Okay, in this column AB, one load is acting. So this loading is also creating some asymmetry in the frame, okay, and this asymmetry is called asymmetry due to the loading. Okay, now in this case, it is most likely that this frame will sway in the right side. Okay, so what we will do, we will divide this problem into two part. We will divide this problem into two part. One part will be sway analysis, okay, and another part will be the non-sway analysis and sway analysis. Firstly, we will do the non-sway analysis, and secondly, we will do the sway analysis. So what we will do in the non-sway analysis, we will assume that this frame will not sway, okay, this frame will not have any sway in any direction. Okay, so if it is not having any sway, then that means, you see, from this example, it is likely that this frame will be having some sway. But if in the non-sway analysis, we assume that there is no sway, that means there should be some support from this side. From this side, there should be one support which will resist that sway. Okay, which will resist that sway. So there is, we have assumed a support here on the top right corner, and that is basically resisting that tilting on the right side. Okay, so this support will give some reaction. Okay, that means the reaction is basically the S, okay, sway force. Okay, so it is called non-sway force. Okay, because we are analyzing the non-sway analysis. So this is S is called the S is the basically the reaction which is produced by this support, and this S, this reaction is acting from right to left. That means its role is to prevent that sway. Is okay. So its role is to prevent that sway. Okay. So we are dividing this example into two figure. So we have assumed one support here, and that support is giving reactions. And if we in the next figure, if we give the this force in the from this side, then this will be this. If you add these two figures, this will be same with this figure. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I'm again repeating. Okay, briefly. So we will divide this type of problem into two part: non-sway analysis and sway analysis. In non-sway analysis, we will have this example, this figure, and we'll divide this figure into two part. Okay, this is non-sway analysis, remember. And in this non-sway analysis, we will assume that this frame will not sway. So if to resist that sway, we should provide some support here on the top right corner that will resist that sway. So we have provided this support, and this support will give some reaction that is called S. Okay, so then we add another figure where we provide this this force. यहाँ पे जो reaction था हम लोग वही force को हम लोग यहाँ पे apply कर देते हैं. That means our frame, if we add these two figure, it will be equivalent to this figure. Okay, this is for non-sway analysis. Okay, we will do this. Okay, then what is the role? What is our target here? Our target is to find this S. Okay, so our target is to find the S or non-sway force, which is is called actually sway force. Sorry. So this S is to has to be found. Okay, from this analysis, and if it is non-sway analysis, then moment distribution method you have to apply. That method is similar to the continuous. अगर non-sway analysis में करेंगे तो हमारा जो moment distribution method होगा वो हमारा जो beam में के case में करते हैं हम लोग वही same case होगा. Okay, after finding the final moments in these columns A, B, and C, D, in these columns, if we find these horizontal reactions here, H A and H D, okay, this is H A and this is H D, then and this is if you take this example, this is equal to S. Okay, so if you take the horizontal equilibrium of this frame, you will get the S. Okay, let me again repeat from some what we will do, we will draw these two figures, and then we will do the moment distribution method for this frame. Okay, for this frame we'll do the moment distribution based on the loading rahega, us sab hum log moment distribution karenge. So what we will get after the moment distribution, we will get the final moments, means we will get the moment in B, we will get the moment in BC, in CB, in CD, and C, in all the members we will get the moments. That is called final moments. Okay, so after getting the final moments, we have to find these reactions. Okay, because it is a frame which is not symmetric, so it will have some horizontal reactions. Okay, so this horizontal reaction, it is acting in the positive direction, HA, this is HA, and this is HD. Okay, so we will assume in the positive direction. Okay, initially when we don't when we don't know the value of the force and we don't know the direction, then in that case we will assume in the positive direction. So HA, this is H and this is HD. Now after getting the final moments, I have explained, I have shown you one such example where we find the reaction horizontal force by taking the moment about B point. If you take the moment about B point, now you will get the HA. If you take the moment about this C point, okay, if you draw the member CD in the separate figure, if you draw the free body diagram, and if you consider the member CD, and if you take moment about C, it is equal to zero, then you will get the HD, okay, horizontal reaction at the D support. Then if you consider the horizontal equilibrium of this total frame, then HA plus HD minus S will be equal to zero, and from that S can be found. So this is the first step of this method. So in the next step, so think, in this frame, what will be the sway? How much it will tilt? We don't know. Okay, na? So how much amount, for how much amount it will tilt on the right side, we don't know. That's why we have assumed that it is will not tilt, and it is called non-sway analysis, and we have assumed support. I found the support reaction, that is sway force S. And in the next figure, we will do the sway analysis. In that sway analysis, we will assume that it will displace by delta amount. It will displace by delta amount here on this side, and here delta amount. Same amount by here. Okay, it will be same for this column and this column. So this is coming under the sway analysis. So in the sway analysis, we are assuming that it will be having the deflection or displacement of delta amount. So now, as you know, if it displaces by delta amount, okay, if it displaces by delta amount, then due to the deflection, some moment will be developed in this column. Okay, like we have seen in this example, this is a fixed support, and also this is a fixed support. So if the right support settled by delta amount in the lower direction, so some moment will be developing in the member. Okay. So similarly here also, if the column is displacing by delta amount on the right side, so some moment will be developed from the direction. Initially, you can assume that if you don't know the value, na delta, is it in the positive direction or negative direction? So initially, we can assume that all the moment will be clockwise. Okay, to avoid the errors. Okay, all the moment will be in the positive direction. So they have assumed the positive direction because they have not taken the sign, means the delta. So just let me finish, you will understand everything. So if the columns are displacing by delta amount, then some moment will be developed in this column. Let the moment be MF1 and here MF1. Same moment will be developing, and same direction will be there. So it is clockwise. Okay. So based on the height, because see, the height of this column is different from that one. So moment will be different from on this column and this column. So let the moment is MF1 and this MF2. After getting that, what you have to do, see, this deflection or this sway is happening due to this some force, and this is called sway force, S dash. Okay, S dash is the sway force, and then we have to apply the moment distribution method again here and find the final moment based on this MF1, MF2. ये वाला जो moment होगा हमारा, है ना, ये सारे मोमेंट के लिए हमें मोमेंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन करना होगा. ठीक है, वी विल डू द मोमेंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मेथड एंड वी विल सॉल्व द टेबल एंड वी विल गेट द मोमेंट, द फाइनल मोमेंट. ओके, फॉर दिस मेंबर्स, ओके, वी विल गेट द फाइनल मोमेंट्स, लाइक द मोमेंट्स विल बी MAB, MBA, MCD एंड MDC विल बी देयर. ओके, सो दीज आर द फाइनल मोमेंट्स, एंड हियर ऑल्सो एज देयर इज सम स्वे इन दिस फ्रेम, this frame. So S dash is the force which is displacing the frame in the right side direction. So S dash is the sway force. So our task is to find the S dash here. Okay. So our task is to find the S dash from these analysis. How can we find the S dash? Again, do the same thing. If we know the final moments MAB, MBA, and if you take the moment about this, this point is equal to zero, and you can get the HA. Similarly, for this column, if you take moment about this point is equal to zero, then you will get the HD, and then you apply the horizontal equilibrium of the force for the total frame. So you will get the S dash. So what I said, is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Maybe you don't know why we are doing this, but my point is my point clear? What I want to convey?
Yes, sir.
Sir, মানে ফার্স্টে হচ্ছে ওই যে ফিক্সড এন্ড মোমেন্ট গুলো বের করব তারপরে সেটা থেকে তো শিয়ার ফোর্সটা বের করব তো
হ্যাঁ ফর দ্য সেকেন্ড প্রবলেম না সেকেন্ড শিয়ার অ্যানালাইসিস উই উইল অ্যাজুম সাম আরবিট্রারি ডেল্টা ওকে এন্ড ইফ দেয়ার ইজ সাম ডেল্টা দ্যাট মিন্স দেয়ার উইল বি সাম মোমেন্ট এন্ড ফ্রম দিস মোমেন্ট উই উইল ডু দ্য মোমেন্ট ডিস্ট্রিবিউশন এন্ড উই উইল গেট দ্য ফাইনাল মোমেন্টস This MAB, MBA, and then we'll get the HA and HD. And if we take the consider the horizontal equilibrium of this frame, we will get the S dash. Now, this S dash is based on the arbitrary sway, is not it? This S dash is based on the arbitrary sway. This delta is unknown basically, but based on this arbitrary delta, we'll find the S dash. So, then what is the next step? So, in our next step, we'll find the factor sway correction factor k that is equal to k in by s dash k equal to s by s dash and final moments see in the non-sway analysis we'll get some final moments okay in the non-sway analysis after solving the non-sway analysis we'll get some final moments right and after solving the sway analysis we'll get the S dash and from S dash we'll find the K and K is equal to S by S dash. So at the end, okay, the final moments of all the analysis will be non-sway moment plus K into sway moment. Non-sway moment plus K into sway moment. So non-sway moment we have, so first table hum log solve karenge usme hame milega. एंड स्वे मोमेंट हमारा सेकेंड टेबल जो होगा उसमें मिलेगा उसके साथ हम लोग के मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे सो दिस विल बी द एक्चुअल मोमेंट इन द फ्रेम इन द मेंबर्स ओके सो हियर वी आवर मेथड इज कंप्लीट सो व्हाई वी आर डूइंग दिस लेट मी ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन सो एज यू नो This is a non-symmetric or unsymmetric beam, frame based on geometry and based on loading. So we will not know the amount of sway in this frame. Amount of sway we don't know. Okay, we cannot say. But in that case, what we have to do? We have to assume some sway. देखो हमारा target क्या होगा? Our target is to find the final moments in each member. Okay, so we will assume that this frame in all members, we have to find the moments. Okay, and then that moment is contributed by the non-sway moment and sway moment. Okay, is it clear?
सर और एक बार सर रिपीट कर दिए ना
आवर टारगेट इज टू फाइंड द फाइनल मोमेंट इन ऑल द मेंबर्स एंड एज वी कैन सी दिस फ्रेम इज नॉट सिमेट्रिक सो द फाइनल मोमेंट इन दिस फ्रेम विल बी कमिंग फ्रॉम द मोमेंट ड्यू टू द लोड्स व्हिच आर देयर दैट मींस फ्रॉम नॉन स्वे एनालिसिस एंड सम मोमेंट विल बी कमिंग फ्रॉम द स्वे दैट मींस फ्रॉम द डिफ्लेक्शन Okay, so each member will be having some moment, and that moment will be contributed by two part. One is the non-sway part, other is the sway part. In the non-sway part, due to the loading, some moment will be there. Okay, jo load isme hoga, uske liye kuch moment aayega har ek member mein. ठीक है. एंड दूसरा जो आएगा कि अगर यहाँ पे स्वे होगा, डिफ्लेक्शन होगा, तो उसके लिए कुछ मोमेंट जनरेट होगा और वो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन होके हमारा एक मोमेंट मिलेगा. तो ये दोनों मोमेंट मिला के हमारा फाइनल मोमेंट, फाइनल एक्चुअल मोमेंट मिलेगा इन ईच मेंबर. बट अभी स्वे वाला पार्ट से कितना मोमेंट आएगा वो हमें पता नहीं है ना, क्योंकि स्वे कितना है वो हमें पता नहीं होगा इनिशियली कि हाउ मच इज द स्वे इन द फ्रेम. So that's why we have assumed some arbitrary sway delta and based on that arbitrary delta, we'll find the moment, fixed moments, and we'll distribute that moment to the other members. That means we will solve the moment distribution method, and that moment will be in proportion with the sway moment. That's why the correction, it is related to the correction. We see in the sway analysis, we find the S dash and we find the K. K is equal to S by S dash. So see, these moments, this sway force is proportional to the non-sway force. Okay, that means these are related. I said now that there will be contribution from two parts, sway part, non-sway part. But these are related in proportion. Okay, in proportion they are related. So arbitrarily we'll find the S dash, and then we'll find the correction factor S by S dash, and the corrected moment, because you don't know the arbitrary moment na. So the corrected moment will be K into sway moment. Jo hame moment milega yahan pe, ye wala jo moment milega MAB, MBA, this is based on the arbitrary moment. But corrected actual moment kya hoga? Actual moment will be the K into these sway moments, and this K is connected to the S. Okay, this K is the connected to the S. So see, it the proportion is same for all the members.
Sir, S or S just mean?
S is the force which is resisting that sway. In the non-sway analysis, and S dash is the force which is creating the sway. See, in this example, there is no loading, so only the sway is there. Due to that deflection, why this deflection is happening? Why this deflection? Because if there is no loading, so how can there be any deflection? So the deflection is due to the S dash. As you know, this frame is not a symmetric frame, so there will be some deflection. So this deflection, how the deflection will come if there is no loading? So that's why S dash is the loading. Okay, this is the method basically, and we have to follow this method to solve, because we have to come to any conclusion. So if there is no loading, how can there be any sway? So this delta, what we have assumed, it is due to this S dash, sway force, S dash. So but this sway force, we don't know how much is this. So it will be in proportion with the this S. This it will be proportional with the this S. Okay, so the relation of S and S dash is K, and this K is called sway correction factor. And this after getting this sway correction factor, we will be getting the final moment. This is arbitrary moment. This is not the actual. There should be some correction, because this delta is arbitrary. So this is not the actual. So the actual will be getting the actual from by multiplying the K with the final moment, which we got from arbitrary analysis.
So, sir, the confusion chilo.
Bolo.
সো বলছিলাম যে এস এস যেটা সেটা হচ্ছে আপনি বললেন যে রিয়াকশনটা,
হ্যাঁ
আচ্ছা এস ড্যাশটা হচ্ছে সোয়ে ফোর্স, তাহলে স্যার সোয়ে ফোর্সটাকে মানে ইকুইলিব্রিয়ামে রাখার জন্যই তো এসটাকে রাখা হচ্ছে।
কোনটা বল, এই পিকচারটা দেখো বলো এবার।
এস যে স্যার রিয়াকশনটা আছে সেটাই তো
হ্যাঁ
আলটিমেটলি
হ্যাঁ
সোয়েটাকে কাউন্টার ব্যালেন্স করার জন্য রাখা,
হ্যাঁ
তবে ওটা আমরা ভ্যালুটা পাবো। তাহলে স্যার এস আর এস ড্যাশের ভ্যালু সমান হওয়ার কথা না?
সমান হওয়ার কথা বলছো?
হুম
সমান হওয়ার কথা তাই মনে হয়, দেখি তারও ভাবি না, সমান হবে না। কারণ হচ্ছে দেখো, এখানে এই সোয়েটাকে রেজিস্ট করছে হচ্ছে এস, এই সাপোর্টটা, যেখানে এই সোয়েটা হচ্ছে তোমার হচ্ছে এই লোড আর হচ্ছে ইউডিএল অ্যান্ড নন সিমেট্রির জন্য এটাকে রেজিস্ট করছে হচ্ছে এই সাপোর্টটা, এই সাপোর্ট রেজিস্ট করছে। সুতরাং কাউন্টার ব্যালেন্স করার জন্য এই যে
তো স্যার আলটিমেটলি পি আর হচ্ছে ইউডিএল এদের জন্যই তো আলটিমেটলি সোয়েটা হচ্ছে,
হুম
অ্যান্ড
হুম
সিমেট্রি প্লাস ওদের যে যে লোডিং।
হুম দেখো, ব্যাপারটাকে যদি এরকম করে ভাবো যে দ্য সোয়ে ইজ ডিউ টু দ্য আনস্ট্রেইন দ্য লোডিং অ্যান্ড আনস্ট্রেইন দ্য হিউমিডিটি, ওকে, সো
তারপর
দ্য
ওটা তো কেটে কেটে
ইফ,
আসবে।
আচ্ছা ইফ উই থিঙ্ক লাইক দ্যাট কি দিস সোয়ে ইজ ডিউ টু দ্য আনসিমেট্রি ইন দ্য লোডিং অ্যাজ ওয়েল অ্যাজ আনসিমেট্রি ইন দ্য জিওমেট্রি, ওকে, সো দ্য আনসিমেট্রি ইন দ্য লোডিং, ডিউ টু দিস আনসিমেট্রি ইন দ্য লোডিং দেয়ার উইল বি সাম সোয়ে অ্যান্ড দিস রেজিস্টার্ড বাই দিস এস, অ্যান্ড দ্য আনসিমেট্রি ইন দ্য জিওমেট্রি দ্যাট ইজ রেজিস্টার্ড বাই দিস এস ড্যাশ। ক্যান উই থিঙ্ক দ্যাট?
মানে স্যার বলছেন যে লোডটার জন্য এস যেটা রিয়াকশন, আর যদি
হুম
উইদাউট লোড শুধু জিওমেট্রি ভাবি তবে এস ড্যাশ।
হুম
স্যার উইদাউট লোড,
লেকিন বেসিক্যালি তো স্যার লোড কে লিয়ে সোয়ে হো রাহা হ্যায় না, তো স্যার করেকশন
হ্যাঁ
ফ্যাক্টর ভি তো লোড কে সাথ হি হোনা চাহিয়ে।
বলো অক্ষয় ফির সে
স্যার
কাকসে।
মতলব করেকশন, স্যার করেকশন তো হম লোগ লোড কে সাথ হি জো কর রাহে হ্যায় ওহি কর রাহে হ্যায় না, তো স্যার আগার জিওমেট্রি কিউ আপ কনসিডার করেঙ্গে।
লোড তো কিছু না কিছু থাকবেই, সেলফ ওয়েট হলেও সেটা একটা না একটা লোড,
হুম
যদি লোড
সেলফ
না
তো
থাকে
থাকছে
মাস না থাকে তবে তো স্যার সোয়ে হচ্ছেই না।
না, থাকবে, বাট সে লোডটাকে ধরা হচ্ছে না এখানে। কারণ হচ্ছে তোমার সে লোডটাকে ধরলে তো আবার ইউডিএল লোড আসবে, এখানে শুধুমাত্র যে ডেল্টার জন্য যে মোমেন্টটা আসছে ওটা ধরছে। মেবি আই হ্যাভ টু টেক সাম টাইম টু আনসার দিস, বিকজ ইউ আর সেইং দ্যাট দিস এস অ্যান্ড দিস এস ড্যাশ শুড বি সেম, বিকজ ইউ আর সেইং দ্যাট দিস সোয়ে ইজ রেজিস্টার্ড বাই দিস এস অ্যান্ড দেয়ার ইজ সাম সোয়ে ডিউ টু দিস এস, এম আই রাইট?
হ্যাঁ স্যার, ইয়েস স্যার। তবে তো স্যার আলটিমেটলি যে ইকুইলিব্রিয়াম কন্ডিশন সেটা যদি এখন না লাগে
হ্যাঁ
তবে তো স্যার এস এর রিয়াকশনটার ভ্যালু পাচ্ছে না।
এসটা তো,
হুম, আর যদি এসটা পেতে হয় তাহলে আমাকে ইকুইলিব্রিয়াম কন্ডিশন লাগাতে হবে। তো ইকুইলিব্রিয়াম মানে
হ্যাঁ
স্যার রাইট সাইড আর লেফট সাইড সমান হওয়া উচিত, তাহলে
হুম
আলটিমেটলি এস ডাস আর এস ইকুয়ালি হওয়া উচিত এই জন্য।
না, এইখানে ইকুইলিব্রিয়াম কোড মানে হচ্ছে ইফ ইউ অ্যাপ্লাই দ্য ইকুইলিব্রিয়াম ফর দিস ফ্রেম ওয়ার ইউ উইল বি হ্যাভিং সাম এইচ এ এইচ ডি অ্যান্ড ইউ উইল ডু দ্য ইকুইলিব্রিয়াম ফর দিস ফ্রেম, দ্যাট ইজ ডিফারেন্ট পার্ট, অ্যান্ড হেয়ার দিস ইজ ডিফারেন্ট পার্ট, ইউ গেট দ্য এইচ এ এইচ ডি অ্যান্ড ইউ উইল গেট দ্য এস ড্যাশ, এস ড্যাশ উইল বি গেটিং, উইল বি গেটিং ফ্রম দিস ফিগার অ্যান্ড এস উইল বি গেটিং ফ্রম দিস ফিগার। নাও ইউর কোশ্চেন ইজ why is a and a dash are different, is not it?
Yes sir.
Okay, so I will try to do some research, not research, but I will try to answer you maybe in next class. Okay. Now I don't know. Okay.
Okay.
So let us, but see, this is the process, and if you have understood the process, then let us solve one numerical to see how it is happening. Okay. So see, this is one one question where A, B, B, C, C, D is there. So in A, B, the property is given, and the loading is 80 kN. So there is no other load. So no load on any member. So this load is on the joint. Okay. So fixed end moments, final fixed moments in all members is zero, because see, no member is loaded. So this member, no member is loaded. So that's why this in the case of non-sway analysis, fixed end moment of all the members is zero. So if it is zero, then see, this is bigger, and you draw the provided the support here, and this is providing some S. So this reaction will be equal to 80. Okay, this reaction will be equal to 80, because this 80 is creating the will be creating the sway or tilting. So this 80 will be equal to S. So then what will be H and HD? So both will be zero, because there are no other loads. So these handled by this S, this support. So there is no other load. So H and HD will be zero. If you consider the free-body diagram, you will get that. And then sway analysis, in the structure, the sway is assumed to be delta, okay, on the right side. So moments will be 6EI delta by L square. The value of the moment is equal to 6EI delta by L square. So for this column, this is 6EI delta by L square. So put the value of I is 2I here for the member AB, and the length is 6 meter. So if you put the value, you will get the MF1. So see, in the figure, the moment is MF1, MF2. Na? So MF1 basically 6EI by L square. So put the value of 6E into I is 2I, and L is 6 meters. So if you put that, you will get the MF1. Similarly, for MF2, you will get the value 6EI by L square. Ignore the sign, ignore the direction. Now, if MF1 by MF2, that is, if you take the ratio, then you will get this something like this. Is it clear? Hello.
Sir, ratio.
देखो इसमें क्या था, we have to assume some arbitrary sway, na? Delta. Here also delta. Now if there is some delta, so there will be MF1, right? MF2, MF2. So both in this column MF2, in column MF1. ठीक है? तो if we keep this delta as unknown quantity, can we do the moment distribution? It will be very, very much complicated. So if you have to carry this delta unknown quantity, so what we have to do, we have to find this MF1. See, MF1 is equal to 6EI delta by L square, 6EI1 by L1 square. MF2 is equal to 6EI2 by L2 square. Then you take the ratio of this MF1 and MF2. So if you will get this like this, okay. You get like this, and MF1 by MF2, you will get this get like this. So then, based on this ratio, you just assume MF1. Suppose MF1 by MF2 is equal to 1/2. Okay, MF1 by MF2 is coming 1:2. Then you consider MF1 is equal to maybe 50. And MF2 is equal to 100. 1:2 ratio में हमें MF1 and MF2 का assume करना है. Okay, definite एक value होगा 50 and 100 maybe 30 and 60. So based on that definite मतलब digit, we have to do the moment distribution method. because you cannot do the moment distribution based on these 6EI delta by L square. Okay, you will not get any value. So based on those arbitrary value, that means if we find the ratio of these moments, then from that ratio we assume some value, and that value should be in proportion with this ratio. Okay, so you see here, so the first column 6EI1, 6E2I into delta by L square. The second column 6E into 1.5I into delta by L square. So the ratio is equal to, if you take the ratio of these two, then you will get 16/27. So is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
So now you will consider the moment in AB, it is equal to minus 16, because see, fixed moments are actually negative. So in this column, the moments we have assumed, it is in positive direction. But it is having the soil like this. So the moment will be like this. Actual moment will be like this, anti-clockwise, right? So from this ratio, you assume the moment will be equal to minus 16, because it should be actually anti-clockwise. Okay. And the moment in the DC, it is equal to minus 27. Right.
Yes.
Then we do the moment distribution. We find the table, this distribution factor table, and we will solve the moment distribution table, and we will get these moments. Final moments is this. So see, this is shown in the figure. This figure, final moment is shown here in these columns. And after getting the final moments, you take the moment about this D, moment about this B is equal to zero. So if you consider moment about B is equal to zero, so there will be a force HA. So HA into this height is plus. Okay, you can do it now. So initially in the general expression, they have assumed it is clockwise, and it is clockwise, and it is also in positive direction. So they have got HA. We have got HA equal to MAB, this moment plus this moment by this height. Okay. So after getting the final moment, you just put the moment here in this, you just show it, and then you apply the equilibrium condition or okay, so if you consider the moment about this V point is equal to zero, so you will get the HA, these reactions, and you will get the reaction for this member also. And sir, after getting this HA and H, yes?
Sir, ye to matlab sir, left side mein sway hona chahiye tha na.
Left side mein kyun?
Sir, right side mein, sir, sway to right side mein hona chahiye tha na.
Wohi to hua hai.
Sir, to right side mein to sir clockwise ho jayega na.
राइट साइड में
हाँ सर
ये वाले में
हाँ सर
कौन सा मेंबर का नाम बताओ
सर ए बी में
है ना
सर
देखो इस किताब में क्या किया ना सारा मोमेंट जो है क्लॉकवाइज लिया है अगर सोए तुम्हारा क्या है कि राइट साइड में होगा तो ये मोमेंट किस तरह का होगा? इट विल बी ट्राइंग टू रेजिस्ट दैट मोमेंट ना। अगर मान लो कि सोए इट इज हैपनिंग लाइक दिस, ओके, तो इट्स रोल इट्स टू रेजिस्ट दैट, सो इट विल बी इन दिस डायरेक्शन। Am I correct?
यस सर।
But what they have considered, they have considered all the moments in the positive directions, clockwise directions.
ओके
That's
सर,
why they have
माइनर।
kept the sign here.
ठीक है सर।
Okay. So then you will get the HA and HD from this analysis, and you will get the S dash. Okay, accordingly you will get the S dash. You do it in your own way. You try it, otherwise it will not happen. You will not. You can't solve. So do it in your own way. What do you know? So this HA, after getting HA and HD, you will get the S dash, and then K is equal to S by S dash. So the final moment table is there. Assume sway moment from assume sway, that is -12.77. This that is basically from this table. Okay, this is based on assumed sway moments due to the assumed sway. So actual sway is equal to this into this 6.837 this. And from the non-sway analysis, you see moments are zero because there was no moment here in the non-sway analysis. All the members is the moment is zero. So no moment distribution table was solved. So moment from that it is zero, 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 zero. So and the end final moment is equal to this plus this, this plus this, this is this. So this is the final moment. Okay.
यस सर।
So you just try by this method, and I will try to understand. Means I have. I will try to explore this answer for this H dash and S. Okay. But this is the method everywhere it is used, and you have to use this method in this way. You have to remember what are the steps. Okay.
Okay.